Hello everyone, so this is me back with another video. This time it's nothing to do with about motorcycles. This time it's a video about your car and an issue that most of us might face during this lockdown or during this COVID scenario. So because it's COVID because the government has implemented a lockdown, most of us are not going out, and as a result we are not using our cars anymore. So if you don't use our cars often, or if you don't use a car for more than a month, so what happens is there is a chance that your battery might drain, especially if your car is like quite old. So I have a Verna over here. This is like 9 years old Verna, and I believe I haven't used it for quite some time. I haven't used it for a month since the lockdown was announced here, and as a result today morning I was trying to start the car, and what I observed is that the battery is drained. So as a result, the car will not start. You can see this is what the car does when I try to start it, right? So what do you do in this case, right? So we need a way to charge your car battery, right? So your house runs on AC, that's alternating current, while your car runs on direct current. So all the wiring in your house is designed for alternating current. The current that comes out of your wall socket is AC or alternating current, but you need DC or direct current for your car, right? So the easiest way to charge your battery is to call your mechanic, your local mechanic. He's gonna come here with a spare battery and then he's gonna fix it. But since it's COVID season and I do not recommend you going out without a reason or inviting a stranger to your house for safety purposes, so I'd recommend if you could charge this at home itself, all by yourself, right? But how do you charge a car battery at home? So as I told already, you cannot just remove the car battery and plug into your wall socket, because AC comes out of your wall socket, and if you plug your DC battery into it, it's just going to blow up. So you need something like a rectifier that will convert AC current to DC current. See, all of your mobile chargers or your laptop chargers have a rectifier built into them that will convert AC to DC, but the capacity on them is very little. They are designed to charge small batteries. So if you try to charge a car battery with your laptop charger or with your mobile charger, your smartphone charger, it's going to take a long time. So I was wondering, what else do you have at home that has this capacity to charge your car battery? And that's when I realized most homes have an inverter at home, right? The inverter that powers your house when there is load shedding or when there is a power cut in your house. So that inverter is used to charge a pretty big battery, a 12 volt battery. So we could use the same inverter to charge the car battery, right? So let me show how it's done. So first of all, you need to remove the car battery out. That's quite simple. All you need is a 10 mm ring spanner, and you can also use the same 10 mm ring spanner to remove this nut over here as well. So that is quite simple. So once you easily remove that out, so once this is removed, we'll go ahead and remove the car battery. So I have removed the car battery out. So this is my car battery, and most important, this is my inverter. I have a V-Guard inverter at home. So it has the same 12 volt battery, but it has more, the amp that it produces is a little more than what the car needs. But that's fine. So I'll just show you how the connections have to be made. So on your battery, you will see a positive and a negative side. So one more thing is, it's better if you have these clips. So I had purchased these connection clips for my motorcycle. I have a portable tire inflator that I use for my long rides. So it needs these connection clips to connect to the battery and then to the tire inflator. So I'm using the same here. So you have this positive and the negative end. And for these sides, I'm using the clips from the clothes line, the clips that you use to dry your clothes, right? So you have a positive on the battery and the negative on the battery. And you have the same over here on your inverter as well. You will have a positive and a negative end. So the positive end usually will have a red wire, the negative will have a black wire, right? So what you do the same thing. You take your positive from the battery, from your car battery. You make sure the positive side of your car battery goes into the positive side of your inverter, and do the same for the negative one as well. So all you do is just plug this one here, right? And the positive from the battery goes into the positive of the inverter, and the negative from the battery goes into the negative of the inverter. So the output of your home inverter is a lot more than what the alternator of your car gives out. So it will hardly take some 20 or 30 minutes is what I guess it will take to charge this battery. So just we'll wait for another 20 minutes and then we'll take this out. Hey guys, it's been like half an hour now. So let me just go ahead and disconnect the wires. So while disconnecting the wires, right, always make sure you disconnect the ground or the negative end first. This is to avoid sparks, right? So once you remove this, then go ahead and remove the positive end, and then you can disconnect the wires from your battery as well. So I need to carry this battery to the car, so I'll be cutting the video for now. Hey everyone, so I'm done with charging the battery. So I'm just connecting the battery back to the car. So I am using this spanner, and one mistake that most people do when they are connecting the battery back is the spanner that they use, right? The spanner that they use when they are trying to tighten the nuts, they accidentally short both the positive and the negative electrodes using the spanner. So you have to always be careful when you are doing this and make sure that the spanner doesn't touch the positive and the negative part when you are tightening the nuts. So I'm done with tightening the nuts. So let's go and try to switch, turn on the car. This is the moment of truth. Here we go. Let's put the key in. Make sure the car is in neutral. And then all the lights, my dashboard is all glowing. My stereo system is up. And now let's try turning on the car. Yes. And my car is running. So let me just give it some fuel. This is good. So this is it, guys. So if during this lockdown, if you haven't taken your car out for quite some time and that has resulted in your battery draining out, so the easiest way to recharge your battery without calling in a mechanic or without you yourself going out is to use your home inverter. That is, if you have a home inverter, just connect the battery to the home inverter and leave it there for like half an hour or 45 minutes. And then your car will be back up. And once you connect it, make sure you leave a car running for quite some time. So my fan belt has some issues. The sound that you are hearing is from my fan belt. I need to wax it. So other than that, everything seems to be fine. So thank you for watching the video, and if you have liked the video or if you have found the video informative, please give me a thumbs up. Thank you.